Jennifer Pike, and I'm really looking forward to playing with the Orchestra of the Swan coming up this month with three performances of Mozart 3. I'm really looking forward to it. So the violin I'm playing on is a Matteo Goffrilla Venetian instrument made in 1708, and it's really beautiful. It's got this amber-like warm tone quality, especially on the lower register, and the sweetness in the middle and upper, so I'm really lucky to be able to play it. And I have played it for, well, more than 15 years now, so it will be there for the Mozart. First of all, after the BBC Young Musician of the Year competition back in 2002, somebody very kindly said, "Would you like to play this violin?" So I was very honoured to be able to get my hands on it then. And ever since, it's gone through various different hands, various different owners, and the Violin Trust and Nigel Brown helped me to secure it. So I'm very happy to say, finally, it is in my possession. I couldn't bear to be apart from this beautiful instrument, so hopefully it will never leave my hands. But of course I love playing other instruments too. They have very different personalities, and so I feel lucky that sometimes I do play other old Strads and Guarneris, so yes, it's a real honour. I really love playing Mozart's Concerto No. 3 in G major because it has this amazing character, a wonderful change of mood at all times. It's sweet, it's witty, it's nostalgic. Every beat there seems to be a different mood. And of course it's got that famous slow movement which uses the flutes, which is sort of unusual for Mozart, and it gives it this beautiful sweet colour. So every movement has a sparkling gem surprise in it somewhere, so I won't give away too much. I think a huge number of young people really do love classical music, so I don't think it's a real problem. What is difficult is getting young people into the concert hall, because that is a space that is quite difficult to get to. There's so much online material, which is wonderful in its own way, but I don't think you can really beat the live concert hall experience with the sort of vibrations of the orchestra kind of reaching the back of the hall. It's a wonderful sensation. So I think really it starts at school. I think it starts in education, something that people are saying all the time, and it sounds a bit of a cliche, but I really do believe it's the true way. It's to get those kids interested in music and give them the chance to be interested in classical music from a young age before they think what's cool and what isn't. It's going to be a real joy to perform in these three great venues with David Curtis and Franz Krieger as well. See you there, I hope.